بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters, yesterday we spoke about the seven wells of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we mentioned one of them, which is Bir Faris. And we said the six others are Gars وبضاعة وروما والعين وبيروحاء والبوصة. Imam al-Samhudi in his book وفاء وفاء بأخبار دار المصطفى says إذا رمت آبار النبي بطيبة فعدتها سبع سواء بلا وهن أريس وغرس بوصة وبضاعة رومة قلبي رحاء مع العهد. Today we continue with another well, which is روما, the well of روما, or well known as the well of سيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه. In the early days of the Muslims in Medina, their life was really hard. It was difficult for them. Medina was known for the lack of water. There were many wells, but most of the wells were not sweet. So most of the water was salty and not drinkable. Second thing, Medina was known before Islam to have a disease, waba. This disease is fever. And it was known that whoever enters Medina and he is not from Medina originally will catch this fever. Even there is a place called Thaniyat al-Wada', the curve in the road where they bade people farewell, because then they just die because of this fever. The Jews who were dwellers in Medina used this situation and played with the minds of the Arabs. So they told the Arabs, unless each one of you who are newcomers to Medina stand on a hill and produce a sound similar to that of a donkey 10 times, you will not get cured of this fever. And they call this a tashir, 10 times braying, 10 times producing the sound of a donkey. And Arabs before Islam just believed them and used to do the same thing, braying 10 times. Until Urwa ibn al-Wird, who is a poet from Qabila Abs, known as Ahad Shu'ara al-Sa'aliq, said that it is more dignified for me to die than to produce 10 times like a donkey. I will not do this. And he did not catch fever. And so the people, so that he's safe and sound, nothing happened to him, so they all stopped the tashir al-muzri, this sound of a donkey. But what happened is that when the Muslims first came to Medina, they caught fever. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Sayyidina Bilal caught this fever. In fact, it was very hard for them and very severe that Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha says that she went to see how her father, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, feels, and Sayyidina Bilal. And she found that they are very hot, their temperature was very hot, extremely hot, and they were speaking unconsciously while they are in this fever. Sayyidina Bilal was saying lines of poetry while he is unconscious. He was saying, أَلَا لَيْتَ شَعْرِي هَلْ أَبِيتَنَّ لَيْلَةً بِوَادٍ وَحَوْلِي إِذْخَرٌ وَحَلِيلٌ وهل أردن يوما ماء لجنة ويبدو لعيني شامة وطفيل. These are places in which he used to live in Medina, in Mecca. And so unconsciously, he yearns amongst to his days in Mecca. So Sayyida Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha came to the Prophet ﷺ and told him what she heard from Bilal and Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq while they were unconscious. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam felt so sad because this is the Medina that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to migrate to. So he collected and gathered all the Muslims and went to a place known as Al-Naqa in Medina, which is very pure air. And there he began supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, Allahumma habbib ilayna al-Madina kuhubbina makkata aw ashad. Ya Allah, make Medina more beloved to us than Mecca. اللهم اجعل بالمدينة طرفي ما ببركة من المركة. Allah making Medina the blessings double and more than double that is in Mecca. Allahumma sahhih lana al-Madinah. Ya Allah, make the atmosphere of Medina sound and more healthy for us. وَلْقُلْ وَبَاءَهَا خَارِجَ الْمَدِينَةِ And move the fever of Medina, the disease of Medina, out of it. Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum say that next day they saw like a figure of a black woman with her hair, and she is running away out of Medina, and the Prophet said, you have seen the fever of Medina leaving it. So it was a very hard time for them. One of the hardships that they faced was that in order to drink good water, they have to move and walk a long distance to the north till they reach the Bir of Roma. Roma was a Jew in the north. So he used this situation and made them pay for the water. So they used to sell this water and purchase it. And the Prophet said, "Man yashtari Roma bi'aynin fil Jannah." Whoever purchases this well and makes it a waqf for Muslims for free, inshallah, he will have an equal spring of water in Jannah, in paradise. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, who is also a forerunner in doing good deeds,